This music just doesn't miss.
This music is not it.
We're chilling.
Don't worry about it.
I got the chill music.
I'll say I said it doesn't. This music is always good.
Oh shit!
I mean, you can change it. I don't care.
But no, I'm putting it back on because it's too late. The
somber tones of Silent Hill and what is it?
Hidden Valley, Black Hill,
Hidden Ranch,
Black Hill.
Let's see. Where do we start? We started
with your
at the combat. Oh, right. Yeah. As we egressed through the, why is that turn order there?
Don't worry about that.
Why is our turn order on the screen?
Focus
up,
man.
My fight or flight is just that trigger button.
We're going to start fighting and start having to use like the letters as like
you are not breathing manually.
Okay. So we went through the wall, the away team, I'll call us. And when we pushed through, Clint got a vision. He was pulled from his body for unsurprisingly out-of-body experience, in which he awoke in a tent somewhere in the wilds. He left the tent and saw King Garth-Mod in his awesome and honorable glory. He was just tending a fire, chilling. You know? He invited Clint to sit down, let's have a chat, you know, all that good stuff, and he talked about the state of the world and things to come. As well as, I guess, the shared nature between him and Clint of not being able to stop pursuing. There were some ominous cracks of thunder out in the distance. One in the very beginning of the conversation, one which was the concluder of it. But he just basically gave a omen, an ominous warning of things are about to hit the fan. And now is the time that you gotta muster up. Clint asked his own questions, particularly about the Queen, to which the King found that their relationship is irreconcilable, but he still loves her. But the vision faded. And then we had fully gone through the wall. Clint asked Bradford if he caught what just happened. Which, obviously, Clint was the only one that went across. Bradford had caught that Clint had zoned out, as he's off to do. But we didn't get too much of a moment to break that down, crack into that, as Island was sniped. Not instantaneously killed, fortunately, but instantaneously downed, at the very least. Brought her back to full HP, dumped all my healing light charges on her. And then Bradford and Thatcher went abounding, chasing down the sniper, which was perched atop the wall that we had just went through. Side note, when Clint talked to Bradford, they both got the benefits of a long rest, so that's a win. Managed to get hold of Sarah the sniper, and fling her down the wall. Was it fling her down? It wasn't fling, it was more of a grab her and both of you fall down the wall.
Suplex
off the wall. It's a hell dive off the wall.
Next from to the top rope!
Exactly. Next to suicidally suplex her off the wall, yes.
She unfortunately managed to break out of your grasp midway, and I forget, did she UT?
No.
Or did she...
She hit the ground. She broke out of his grasp, hit the ground, was about to start shooting at him, but that's when Red Fox dipped in, and she just kind of dipped.
What a woman.
Seemingly turning at least partially invisible. Which Bradford was still able to track her for a minute, but so was Thatcher up top, who was now in a sniper position.
Yep, so Red Fox and Thatcher were in pursuit, Bradford regrouped to the party, and we began making our way over to Salazar's Combat Grove. Which was in its final wrap-up moments. Salazar being handled by Uriah, Jericho, but then when Jericho went down, Augustus entered the equation, and I think it's his T2 that he used on Salazar, mm-hmm. which just hyper-cooked him. A lot of... I don't remember them off the top of my head, unfortunately, but they're all, like... I guess not biblically based, but, like, halfway there, because there's, like, glory to the crown and stuff like that, which isn't biblical.
They read like our oaths that we swear, almost.
In a way, yeah.
Yeah.
It was, like, his knight's oaths.
Yes.
And the naming.
Pretty cool, pretty cool. Salazar is defeated, but not dead. Which, but she sort of did tell us that he's just like, hey, there's more than two of you, I'm not gonna do it. The people that were soul banished by Lucian re-entered their digital, or not digital, their mechanical constructs. And the onslaught continued, but we showed up to assist. We banished Rena, and then her body promptly self-detonated. So that sort of sucks in terms of getting some samples, but oh well. And then Chadford
starts mewing,
blinded Eric, going ape on her, and then ran off like the monkey he is. She is not pleased by this.
She's like, why did I decide to be the fucking hero?
Yeah. But fortunately, we have Aislinn with her magical powers restored, so she was fixed up pretty promptly thereafter. We got a sit-rep on the current situation. Dark ones, the basic ones, like the Dunesmen, the Huntsmen, the Bogsmen, are flooding in here with their greater counterparts, our HVTs. And they're sweeping south, and they're gonna meet us sooner rather than later. The rest of the Boa Cooks were already in and are gonna meet us at the center. Dayron is currently contesting against. Caster didn't say he's fighting Leona, right? Because Leona's last scene with Gregor, and Caster just right. left after that to regroup with us.
He just said he's not gonna turn down a fight.
Yeah. So Dayron's still there. And we got to go regroup with him. We got a Song of Restin. So that's a win. Talk to Rena. And she's currently an occupant in Clint's head hostel. One of two guests. Can we get it to three? Who knows? We were making our way over to the bridge. Making sure that Aizen wasn't going to get sniped. Red Fox and Thatcher are regrouping with us. When mecha fucking shows up. I know he's not a mecha tech bomb, but he looks like that. I'm gonna keep calling it because it sounds funny. Does 1d100 damage. Really, really hoping he targets one of us and does one damage. I'm really, really hoping for that because
I want at least like tell. Single digits at one point.
I'll take that.
Unless we can target his horn and have him blast Leona for 100, then I'll take a triple digit.
He attacked me, right?
You tried to, but I think you didn't take damage because you got the save.
Yeah, it was an all or nothing save. Oh, yeah, it's a charisma save.
Yeah, so you were...
So I'm the best person to take it. We made it to the edge of the pupil. I'll keep calling it that, the pupil. Of God's Eye. And we're gonna make a very, very fast descent down into it. We're going to jump off the edge and then feather fall at the last couple of feet. Couple tenths of feet. But in the background, a fog cloud is rolling in that we're gonna jump through so we don't get shot at. And Jericho was lingering in the fog. And pounced on the mecha tech long and is plummeting to the ground.
Hell
like,
yeah.
Barely succeeding in the grapples, if I remember correctly.
Or else he has literally a mechanic to kick your ass off.
Could buck you.
God dang it, I so wanted to do that, but...
It would have been fucking choice. Glad you failed, though.
And I think that's it. I think the only question marks still left is, where's Michael? Because he said he was going to regroup with us. And out of the God's Eye arena, two was making his way to the barracks, our barracks, the Crimson Team barracks, because shit's going down! Don't know what's happening when he came across Lady Catrice? Was it Catrice? Yeah, Lady Catrice. Lady Catrice, her husband, whose lordship name I don't recall, if I'm being honest, and Naomi, who were in the middle of, I guess, doing, like, not autopsy, but medical diagnosis on some downed people, but they're also fighting against a couple Black Watch members. And then two threw his lot in against the Black Watch members.
Yeah, what a traitor.
Yeah.
Bro, what the fuck, dude?
That's us.
Record scratch. Hi. You might be wondering how I got here.
And I think bro, can't even recognize whose team. Crazy.
Leave it to the goblin.
The Chaos Bringers, that's true.
I think the only other thing we didn't cover is Jericho did try to get a sit rep from Gregor, to which there was no response.
No reply.
Yes. Maybe he's just in another dimension.
Maybe he's left him on red.
Ugh, this guy again.
he's so obsessed with me.
Jericho, parenthesis, spam, end parenthesis.
Yep, so I think that sounds about right on my end, unless y'all have anything else to add.
Nope. I think maybe rice out there.
Hear some choking on rice outside?
What?
Huh? Sound like someone was choking outside in my room.
Oh, that's really cool.
You want to go give a Heimlich maneuver on them?
No,
faster?
That's outside my room.
That's outside my room.
Right. It's outside my jurisdiction and care. The only thing I can add is I think we grabbed some samples from the detonated Rena. Like some of the metallic samples and something like that. But that's it.
Okay.
Okay. Sound like Katie.
Okay. Why did you say that name?
She's been dead for years.
God, what a fucking dog shit plot point.
Okay.
Whoever thought of that, honestly. Anyways.
Uh-huh.
So, Crash Cop Robinson.
Oh, shit.
You got it.
I don't have her token set up. That's fine. I got a sheet.
You don't?
Yeah, it doesn't have the HP bar. I don't need it. Yeah, that tracks. That tracks.
So, you decided to be mid.
Listen. Yes.
Good, like. Good song.
Oh, yeah. We probably should have just done a song.
Lady Cartoon.
Yeah, we need a bop.
Ooh, I think I was someone.
Who's Lady Cartes?
Her, apparently.
No, I didn't. Oh, I did.
Lady Cartes of Schoppenberg.
Oh, no.
Cart shopping. What'd you do? What was this bit for?
I spelled it wrong. What do you mean?
Schoppenkart.
Cup and carton.
There you go. Like it never even happened.
I didn't just spell it wrong once. I spelled it wrong twice because it's on the sheet as well.
I am.
Ortiz.
Tough being.
Some Mexican simple. Stand-up.
I think it looks like it. That's why I went with it. Maybe I said something different.
Kind of.
Shamashian standoff.
Yeah, I thought so. It's so sick.
Alright, what do you got, Booyah?
Yeah, we're still in the pack at 25.
I am. Oh no.
I don't like this.
Which is crazy. Mr. Flat Zero is second.
Holy shit, wait, he has a... Wait, really?
Flat Zero.
Fuck.
Just rolled like a god.
Unlike his lady wife. I think he's also sitting at a hard flat zero.
At least I'm not last.
So don't want to try to talk this out or just go straight in to kill him?
I mean, you see a bunch of dead bodies. You see this watchman known as Jack charging at Naomi. Looks like there is some type of ambush here.
Alright, let's get into it.
Roll a perception.
Got it.
He has his ring. Does he have his ring still? Has it been a new day since he got taken by ladies?
See, holding up a shield but trying to tend to this body is a ritzy looking man with a long cloak with half his neck severed and a golden crown covered in blood on it.
Ah, shit. That's the king.
It was.
No.
A king.
Let's get into it, shall we? Come on.
Do it.
Alright. One attack.
Okay.
22 Oof. Hits, yeah.
Okay, I'll throw my bonus on there real quick. Is it gonna load?
What are you thinking?
Is it gonna load?
Rotani.
Okay, there Nobody. We go. I'm not cursed yet. Okay.
Also hits.
Let's add a hamstring on one of those at level 2.
Ooh, by the way. Go ahead and take me 6 damage.
Ooh. I can take that.
Actually, you would take 11.
Targets within the 20 foot. Okay, so I'm a movement speed reduced, right?
Correct.
Gotcha.
Here, let me just put it up.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
Use a nice, cool, icy color.
Pale blue.
Oh, well, that there goes my plan of getting away from.
How far were you?
I was 40 feet. I have 50 feet movement.
You are now 0 feet movement, is what I'm hearing.
Well, dinner bell!
You can't take up 2 attacks against me. Downside. You don't even have the option.
So, yes, what a hamstring to that. Let me load that up. Yeah. If I'm stuck, he's stuck.
Sure.
I'm not stuck.
Stuck in here with me!
Constitution save. What's your DC?
Alright, what's the DC? It's a con save.
It is a con save.
Roll a d8 for that to actually do some damage.
Does it do more at second level?
It does. No, it doesn't do more at second level. But
what are we talking about for like a 24?
What's his mod? Plus 8?
Damn.
If you amp up the technique with a spell slot, it does do more damage. It's your wisdom mod.
What's your DC?
I haven't had to look at this chart in a while.
I could still rebarb it, assuming that this is an ambush and no reaction.
DC 17.
Ooh, I think a 24 gets there.
I don't think.
Am I
17 or 18 seems.
Am I surprised or no?
No, because you would have been here a little into the gambit. Okay. And it does seem like they're specifically targeting high-value nobles.
Sweet. I'm a lesser noble. Let's go.
Correct, yeah. Seems their goal is on Lord Carwin.
Okay, if that's the case, then Can he roll one more time? Fingers crossed, fingers crossed. Fail. I see that bless. That's not a good sign, but... Ah, the bless.
He did not fail.
Damn it. Okay. I'll give the advantage over to the good lord himself, since he's the target, and he's also coming up next.
Very good. Anything else?
I think that's my attack. Bonus action, I attacked. Movement, I think that's it for me.
You're supposed to have 10 more feet of movement. But then this damn coal. What doth Lord Octavius do?
Alright, let's... Can't get up to the roof, but he can do combat. Actually, he'll fall back this way. We will... Let's roll an int save. That's to GM. It was a 20. He's a smart guy.
He had advantage on it, too, if it matters.
Oh. Okay, so it's a 20.
Damn, plus 9. It's him. His lordship cubed.
Oh. Alright, let's see. That'll work. Oh, where did her sheet go? Yeah. All right, so one shot at both Uyag and Naomi.
Send.
Do it.
Achoo.
Oh.
That's not good.
You love to see it.
Which one is that against?
Both of you.
Oh, it's one singular roll, I see.
Correct.
That's rough. I'm wearing heavy armor, and these aren't dark ones, so there's the damage mitigation does apply, correct, right?
Yeah, that is -3.
Okay.
So you see this dark bolt shoot between the two of you, then bounce off both of you and shoot back to the other one. So this one to Naomi, this one to Booyah.
Doesn't hit me.
Before a firebolt shoots another one between the two. Chew. I don't think that hits though. Well, my hit Booyah. Nope.
No.
That misses everyone.
No.
You see him just say, look over. Shit, what do we do? Take her and let's get out of here. So they switch their target to you, now realizing
shit,
the other one might be out of hand.
Shit.
Swing.
Hits.
Let's see, what's going to be better?
-8.
He is going to bank on your con save being worse than your armor.
Let's see. Bonus action makes one. It's one of the con save against one creature. It's one. Okay. What's the DC? 18, 19.
It is 17.
Okay. Phew! Shit.
Hey! Let's go.
Arcane. Ah, another takes a reaction. Shit, never mind.
So 21, and you are basically under the effects of slow.
Wait! It's been a while since I had to use my sheets. I am lucky.
Okay.
So it has like a plus like 7, so it's like a 50-50 shot, right? Right.
Hey.
Blessed be the light, blessed be the light.
As he shoots back you, behind you as you dodge, he turns on this icy path before rapidly raising up his blade, which is turned hard ice.
Oh my god!
Why are they critting so much?
Crit city over here!
Oh, they also have extended crit range?
Let's see.
Damn. Okay.
27, 36, 45, 42 total.
Minus 3 is 39.
No, that was minus the 3.
Oh, that was with the minus 3, thank you.
Yeah.
What'd you say it was, 42? 42. 42. I'm still standing!
And that is all he does on his turn. What do you got?
Lord, oh lord, I am hurting.
What do you got? Craig.
Hmm. Yeah, my daughter's turning.
I thought I heard that too.
My bad.
Action, I'm going to spend 25 lay on hands points on myself. Because I am hurting. So that's my main action. Bonus action.
Cure wound on myself. Or, peel wound.
Bonus action. If they're targeting me, then I'm gonna make them work for it.
Hell yeah.
Question for the speed debuff wise, if you leave the aura, do you get the speed back, or is it like as soon as you enter the aura, you just lose 10 speed?
You lose the 10 speed.
Gotcha. Okay. I am going. This is like fireball range. But these are washed, but what are the chances of them being high casters, right? I will move over. Actually, I'm gonna move over here. Or over here, actually.
Oh, you're moving. I love to see it. Yeah, we love all that. How much are you moving?
I was like right here, right? So, 15.
Love to see it. Six damage.
Okay. I'm setting up for the flanking, though. And that's my turn.
All right. Let's,
Do you want me to change
do
that?
This? What? That is brutally bad.
What's the roll on it? 3d8 plus 5. So she rolled an 8 on a 3d8. That's really bad.
Well, TL for 13, y'all.
Hey, we did it. Hey, every little bit helps.
Well, she's going to move first, because that would be smart. Actually, no, she doesn't move.
Or is she just here before? No, she's here before.
And then misses. You love to see it.
That healing is for everyone, right?
Correct. Everyone on your side.
Okay, yeah, of course. All right. I haven't played 2 in a while. My soul flare, is it round 2 or round 3?
It's tier 1 is round after you use your action in round 1.
Okay.
So as long as you use your action in round 1, you can use it.
All right. What's the distance here?
I wonder how that works, cuz normally you use it against dark ones and they have like traits that you steal. How does it work on...
I get to take a trophy at least, and that helps me do extra damage. So.
True.
I'll take it.
All right.
One attack. Oh wow, okay.
Oh, miss.
Is Jack into does Jack
that one does hit.
Flank by chance?
No. Oh, that one doesn't hit. Oh. You need to get here to
You wanna move one space up? You wanna flank?
Oh yeah, let's flank.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead and take said, 5 it's been cold a while. Damage for your troubles.
Sheesh, 4 damage.
Alright, I'll take that damage.
Crash, would you do me a favor and switch songs?
Yeah, I see it. Long command, long bot.
Are you letting him reroll those with advantage because of the flank?
Nah, bro.
Ooh, metal.
That's alright.
Action bonus.
Let's see. Yeah, I think I'll use Ghost Step. Two, three. Yeah. That way, at least I'm still here, but I'm invisible.
Okay.
I like the song, I got that rising tension.
Alright, anything else?
That'll be all.
Who's that?
Oh no.
Harlequin walked out. That looks sick though.
That's
oh,
good.
The crits! He's only critting today! What the hell? He's on our side? Y'all. We have a clown on our side, let's go.
Honk honk.
I gotta give the Joker title to him.
Let's see, how do we... How do we finish? Let's make another attack.
Oh, high roller.
How do you find the clown in armor?
I don't know where you found this, but I'm sad that I didn't find it first. I would love to use the sword.
And then... replace his third attack, but with a talented ability.
What's the ability?
Talent, you say?
Lightning bolt! I replaced my attack with fuck you lightning. A full action spell, in fact.
I didn't roll. I'll roll the fireballs in here. Fireball.
Yeah, it's the same damage. Well, not damage type, but... okay. That's average, I think. Maybe a bit below.
Oh, yeah. Takes nothing.
Ah, I got that evasion. What about...
takes half. I just definitely did 14 instead of minus 14.
I am now at 14 HP. Something terrible has happened. Ruin has fallen on our house.
Alright, that's all he does on his turn. So you see out of the ether pops up this, I guess, like armored clown type looking character who puts 2 stabs into the back of her and then lets loose a lightning. Let's see. Let's test. The wisdom saves are good too.
Dang, that blessed.
Just barely too.
Oh, is one of them concentrating on Bless?